Two strong companies that have dropped almost 5% today alone. It's been a pretty crazy red day for some of our stocks. So in today's episode, we are gonna take a quick look at a cybersecurity company. We're also gonna take a quick look at a popular online betting company, which most of you are familiar. Like always, we're gonna take a quick look at future growth, fundamentals, technicals, and even valuation metrics. So let's get started. All right, so the first company we are gonna take a look at is PING Identity. As you can tell by the name, they are this one in the cybersecurity market. They kind of do identity authentication. So they have over 2 billion identities right now secured by PING. We can take a quick look at their website. They're trusted by more than 60% of the Fortune 100 companies. And you can see there are a lot of big names of customers behind them. They have plenty of solutions like single sign-on, multi-factor authentication, intelligent API, which detects and blocks cyber attacks using their artificial intelligence. And they also have stuff like access security and so much more. PING Identity is currently traded under the New York Stock Exchange as ticker PING. And as I am recording this episode, the stock is down almost 7% and is sitting at $22.85. From its 52-week high closing, the stock is down about 37% right now. And we can see in the past 52 weeks, this company has seen high movements both in the up and downside. Currently, this is a super small company with a market cap of $1.87 billion. If we take a quick look at future growth, this company is expected to grow 12.2% on average for the next 3 or 5 years. So not a crazy growth stock, but definitely not a slow monster. If we take a quick look at their trailing 12 months, they are not profitable in GAAP earnings, but they are positive in cash flow from operations. Before we take a quick look at their balance sheet though, guys, if I am providing some form of value, make sure to hit the thumbs up and the subscribe button. It really does help with the overall channel. And let's take a quick look. Listen to today's sponsor, a great reason why I'm able to provide so much content to you guys for free. I want to thank The Motley Fool for sponsoring this video. The Motley Fool is a company that provides investing insight and stock recommendations for investors of all skill sets and risk levels. You guys know I love finding new investing tools and resources to help me scout out new growth stocks. And right now I have a discount for one of my favorite services The Fool offers. Through The Motley Fool Stock Advisor Services, you get access to a ton of expert stock picks. Every month you'll get 2 new picks that are aimed at growing your wealth and to help you realize your financial goals. Stock Advisor's average stock picks have done amazing returns. If growing your money is something you'd like to do more of this year, you can visit fool.com/JoseNajarro or click on the link below for access to my special offer and decide if the Stock Advisor is right for you. Thanks again to The Motley Fool, and now onto today's video. So if we take a look at their balance sheet, they have about $55 million of cash and short-term investments and about $40 million in debt. So first thing I'm seeing is fundamentally, this is a company sitting in a great place. If we take a look at their most recent earnings, their annual recurring revenue was about $266 million, which represents about a 16% growth compared to the same time last year. Like we saw, not huge growth. This is not a huge growth company, but it's one not slowing down at the moment. Total revenue was about $69 million, and it was a growth of 12% compared to the same time last year. Right now, subscription revenue represents about 93% of this company's total revenue. Some recent news today, PING Identity announces the pricing of follow-on offering of common stocks by selling shareholders. And I do believe this is the main reason the stock price is down today. The offering is gonna be at $24 per share. This is not your typical offering. PING itself is not selling shares. This offering is existing investors selling out of their position. So PING will not receive any of the proceeds from the sale. And they are making sure to tell investors that this offering will not dilute ownership of any existing shareholders. So even though that's the case, obviously investors hate to see when insiders to some extent are selling, especially such a big position of about 6 million shares. All right, so now the second company we are gonna take a look at is DraftKings. You guys might know them from their sports books or their online sports betting, but they are innovating and becoming so much more than that. DraftKings right now is traded under the NASDAQ as ticker DKNG. As I am recording this video, the stock is down 4.6%, sitting at $48.26. From its 52-week high closing, the stock is down about 33%, and it has a market cap of about $19.4 billion. So we can see it definitely has seen quite a correction. DraftKings right now is expected to grow 28.6% on average for the next 3 to 5 years, so a nice hyper-growth stock. Unfortunately, the company is not profitable, and they're not positive in cash flow from operations. This is something that I would put in the back of investors' minds, right? It doesn't mean it's a bad investment. It just means, hey, there might be some added risk or some added volatility because of this kind of negativity in form of its fundamentals. In form of balance sheet, this company is sitting at a great place. They have about $2.8 billion in cash and about $1.2 billion in debt. The main reason the stock price is down today, an investment research firm did come out saying that after some extensive research, they have taken a short position in DraftKings. So hearing something like that has definitely spooked out a few investors. But if we take a look at their most recent earnings presentations, which were May 7th of 2021, maybe it might cool off some investors. The company reported 175% pro forma revenue growth for quarter one. DraftKings is being very innovative and launching a lot of new products. We can see in this most recent quarter, they kind of did a collaboration with Sling TV, where they team up to launch exclusive sports betting information channels. Customers can currently view real-time game scores and betting odds on DraftKings basketball channel, and baseball and hockey channels have also launched. They are also innovating in the iGaming world. So in April, they launched Spanish 21, which is a unique DraftKings-built casino game. Currently, this game is only available in New Jersey and will start expanding into other states with regulatory approvals. And if you guys have been taking a look at my previous episodes of DraftKings, we can see this is one that has been acquiring a lot of content creation companies. So it's pretty impressive to see where they will go in the future. They're also launching social functions in their application right now. So you'll be able to do commenting, friends, notification, bet sharings, and even have a profile. So we can see DraftKings is adding this social interaction with this platform. So I think that's a great move, because if you go to a casino, right, I'm not a big gambler, I don't go very often, but when I do see this form of social, I do see this form of social world in there, right? People are talking within each other in the tables, having fun, laughing. So that bringing this type of social functionality, I do believe will improve the user experience, and it will also increase user time in their application. So I thought this was a great move for DraftKings. All right, so now let's take a quick look at technicals. I really just want to make sure the stocks aren't overextended. If they are overextended, I do believe there's a higher risk at the moment. Let's start off with PING. PING right now, definitely not overextended. I do believe a good portion of the risk has been eliminated. One thing though is this seems to be a very strong supportive level for this company, so investors should take an eye on that. Now, if we take a look at DraftKings, not overextended either, sitting at great volumes as well. So I do believe a good portion of the risk has been eliminated. Obviously, the stocks can continue to go down. Now, if we take a quick look at valuation metrics for both these companies, I want to take a look at forward price to sales ratio. If we start off with PING right now sitting at about 6.2 forward price to sales ratio, and we can see this is pretty low compared to where the company has been in the past. So it does seem like it's a bit undervalued compared to its historical numbers. Now, if we take a look at DraftKings, it has a price to sales ratio of about 12. This is cheaper than where it's been most of early 2021, but it's not the cheapest it's ever been. All right, so now my overall thoughts. In form of prices, I do believe both of them are sitting at attractive levels. If we're taking a quick look at markets, I believe DraftKings is one I enjoy a little bit more than PING, just because of the overall innovation this company is doing and the type of growth this company can see in the future years. In my portfolio, I can see both of them being a tier two or even a tier three stock, definitely not a tier one though, but I would enjoy DraftKings a little bit more than PING. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's episode. Like always, take care, have a good night, and see you next time.